right. I am on the clock with this. I tried this like several times. If my throat dies, it's like whatever. So we have the Bayonetta 3 controversy. And if you guys aren't aware, or if you're not on social media, like a good majority of people are, because hashtag Twitter is a microcosm and dumb fucks don't understand that, I'm going to reiterate the story to you yet again. So the previous voice actress for Bayonetta, Helena Taylor, decided to say, hey, I feel like Platinum Games does not know my worth as a voice actor and for the legacy of Bayonetta if they offered me a measly 4K just to come back and reprise the role yet again. On top of that, they decided to lie about it and say, oh, we're just gonna get the broom and dustpan and sweep this under the rug. Miss Taylor is busy, therefore, due to scheduling conflicts, she could not reprise the role of Bayonetta yet again. The voice actress then deemed this as bullshit, came out, broke her NDA, put her career on the line, and said, hey, I'm not standing for this. Boycott Bayonetta, decide to take your money and donate it to a charitable organization. This caused a lot of controversy and turmoil and a whole bunch of shit. Now, just like Neve Campbell, where she exited Scream 6, an actress or an actor knows their worth. They know what they need to be paid. If they feel like that's undervalued, I feel like the first thing they will do is communicate. If it doesn't work out, if there is creative difference, they will leave the project or go elsewhere. It's common nature, and thus the game director or game developer will replace them with someone else. Movies too. We heard this same song and dance before with creative difference. I do believe that she is entitled to what she is owed, what she needs to be paid, what she feels is important to her worth as the character. Unless it's like an astronomical ask, like an astronomical amount of money, that's crazy. But I mean, people know their worth all the time. I don't mind her pursuing her bag. That's not the problem. The problem is when people take the word boycott, they run with it, and they're not true to themselves. They're not genuine whatsoever. As soon as she said boycott the game, guess what happened? There was a line in the sand. People were like, nah, I'm not gonna boycott this shit. And I totally understand that. I totally get that mentality, because number one, I mean, it's my money. I'm sorry, people. I don't care how many times you scream it to the rooftops. I don't care how many times you fucking cry about it online. At the end of the day, it is my money, my value, my entertainment. I do whatever it is I want with it. You have no control, and if you think you do, we could just go on the side of the street and handle it out from there. Like, I'm dead serious. I hate when people decide to pocket watch other people and dictate what they do with their cash. But I find the word boycott to be so fake these days. Now, if you're not buying Bayonetta 3, if you're pirating it or whatever, you know, more power to you. Do what you want. I don't care. But when people say it in mass unison, I would believe that the goal in their brains is to make sure that the game flops. Like, that's the ultimate goal. We're the gamers, we're the people, and we have control over every situation. You know, they do put the food on these people's table, but the temptation is always there when people make these easily inflated ego arguments about what worth is, and talking about people they don't even know, etc. And then they break when reviews come out. They were already planning to look forward to the game if they have some sort of addiction to it. It's like a drug addiction. Like, they can't let it go. Therefore, they're already playing the game on launch. Their words mean dick. It doesn't mean any fucking thing of the sort. There are so many people making Bayonetta jump to the top 40s on fucking Amazon. If the goal is to make the game fail, it's not to make the game succeed, in my opinion, right? So it jumped up from being in the low top 40s to jumping up to number 38 as a top seller in the US for the game. So therefore, it brings me to the question of this. Do you not understand, number one, controversy creates cash, right? Controversy creates moolah and exposure each and every single time. So I'm sure, like, definitely there's going to be some bad that comes out of this. But the good news is for Platinum, it put more eyes on Bayonetta for more people to buy the game. In a massive boycott, it should flop. Like, you know what flopped in the past when game developers were so adamant to say, hey, DMC Devil May Cry, you know, we're gonna shit on older Devil May Cry and that's it. That failed. Sales targets all across the board in a united effort. These efforts are not united all of the fucking time because people are fake. People like to fake noble. People like to fake boycott. All talk, no action. Which is why I said on my feed, I don't believe a word some of you motherfuckers say when you bring up boycott, because if the end goal is to make the game flop, it is not to make the game succeed. All right? So I don't believe it. And number one, if I'm looking forward to a piece of media that I want, whether it's a movie, game, etc., I'm not boycotting shit because I don't care enough to do that. Like, I'm looking forward to it. It's my money, it's my opinion. I want to engage with that thing. So unless, like, the director basically went out back and decided to put a shotgun to all of his workers' heads and pull the trigger, I'm not boycotting the game. I'm not doing it. Like, I don't care about your crusading online. I don't care. I don't care about any of that. You do what you want to do. I do what I want to do. I hate when people try to inflect these same principles on everybody else as if I should give a shit. Because number one, you know what people aren't doing for the second part of Helena's message? They aren't giving to those charitable organizations. They are either buying other games or buying Bayonetta 3. It's crazy, okay? So everything she said at the end is all for naught. So why should I throw my arms up in the air and say, hey, now I'm mad at this too? That would be bandwagoning, right? That would be bandwagoning to the highest degree, and I'm not going to do that. Instead, I'm going to call that shit out each and every single time, because I've seen this happen time and time again. We're boycotting, we're mad, and then the movie or game just gets off clean, right? People will say quality is more indicative of what it's supposed to be, but in this case, I heard that Bayonetta has very good previews. It is being previewed very well, and if it continues, guess what's gonna happen, right? Those reviews are gonna come out, they're gonna look good, and then the people advocating for boycotts are going to fold like a cheap burrito, right? Like, it happens every time. Like, I said that, I don't know if I said this here or in a previous recording that got scrapped before my voice decided to conk out and die, but I said the thing with people is that in terms of gaming or entertainment, the main thing that lies in the back of their head is the need to not miss out, no matter what it is. So if you're not buying the game, you're pirating it if it's good. If you're actually going to go out of your way and say, hey, I'm boycotting it, but the thirst gets to you and you buy the game anyway, you're experiencing the game. If you get the game used, you're experiencing the game. You know, it just goes on and back and forth. And I've never heard, or at least I guess if it's a rarity, I never heard someone just simply say, I'm boycotting it, I won't engage with it, that's enough, moving on to the next thing. Because again, controversy creates cash, controversy also creates posts, and those posts are illustrated on the situation, and fans, you know, they think they believe what they're doing in their heart is the morally correct thing to do, but they cannot let go of the addiction to the game, especially if they waited 4 or 5 years for it. So I don't have these problems because I know what I want. I'm very distinct with it. I know what I need, and no other opinion or no other thought process will sway me otherwise. You could be multifaceted in your thoughts. I don't know why everyone thinks everything is a binary choice on social media. That's fucking stupid. That's fucking dumb. You can say, hey, I'm probably gonna try Bayonetta 3 out later down the road, but what they did to that voice actress is definitely some bad behavior, and they should think twice before doing that to someone else again. You can be multifaceted without jumping the gun, right? You could be multifaceted, like what you like, and say, hey, you know, that's crazy how they decided to say, hey, you know, she didn't even try to contact us or whatever. We're going to sweep that under the rug. You could say that. I don't get those who try to impede on fun. I already think those people are miserable as is. And when it comes to reality, when it comes to the truth of how people handle themselves and coordinate things on the internet and try to moral crusade, it just always fails like 9 times out of 10. You get the rare instance where it does, but mostly everyone saying, oh, I'm not gonna buy this, that, and the third. More than likely, my perception is they're full of shit. Or they're gonna engage with it some way. It always happens. It always is a thing. Anyway, my name is Renegade Operative. I am signing out. I just don't believe in boycotting anymore. I said it always on this channel. The best example of someone boycotting something was James Rolfe when he said he's not watching Ghostbusters 2016. He said what he had to say. He said, it's just not part of my childhood, in a civil, fucking dignified fashion. And he decided to let that go, and that was it. No other videos, not like 10s, the 20, the 30 videos giving attention to the said thing. Because, you know, each time you're doing this and you're saying, oh, I hate this and that, and I'm gonna make like 5,000 hate videos, you're just giving said project exposure. Therefore, you might influence an audience member to say, hey, is he really saying all that? Is it really all that bad? I'm gonna check it out myself. Oh wait, now I actually like the game. So you basically sold the game to someone else. It's like advertising, right? I just think people are stupid enough and they don't get it. They don't understand. And it's a conversation that's not for small minds, really. So I'm out. You know, if you're not gonna donate to charitable causes after you pull your money from Bayonetta 3, I don't want to hear shit. I just don't want to hear it. If it's not genuine, if it's not true, if it's not sincere, then what is the point of even saying what you just said? Exactly. I'm signing out. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this Bayonetta 3 rant, and hopefully you really enjoyed it, had fun, you know. I know I normally don't do rants very often, but I figured I might as well just cut the middleman, cut the bullshit, get the biggest knife out the drawer, and cut the bullshit and talk about this whole situation. And that's it, really. You know, I heard Jennifer Hill is in support. She probably had no idea of the situation, but I still don't really agree with the other voice actress throwing her under the bus. But she said, you know, what she said, and I think that came from an emotional place, not a spiteful one. So I don't know. It's all confusing in the land of voice, but sometimes there's creative differences in voice actor work, and this stuff happens. It's not shocking, in my opinion, but people aren't going to tell me what I can and can't do, and I do believe that folks are just fake most of the time when they rally up against something and nothing happens. Like, what is the point? You know what I mean? What if failure is the point, the idea is to not make it success. You know what I mean? So I will see you guys next time. Again, if you have any sort of comments in the video, let me know below and we will talk about it. But until then, that's it. Peace out.